Hello students, good morning. Now this is your social study class. Students, in continuation of the chapter 14, our agriculture, today we are going to learn about fruits. Where it is grown? In the orchard. Okay, so today we are going to learn about fruits. Cultivation of fruits is it comes in the term of horticulture. Okay, so India is the second largest producer of fruits in the world after Brazil. So banana, mango, papaya, guava, apple, etc. are the chief fruits grown in India. Apples are grown in Himachal Pradesh and Kashmir. So this is about fruits. In short, it is given. And now, hurdles associated with agriculture. Okay, hurdles associated with agriculture, that means problems, difficulties that is associated with agriculture, and we must be overcome of it. So what are these? 1. Low level of irrigation system. 2. Land degradation. 3. Lack of proper knowledge of crop rotation, and no proper assess of market by the farmers due to poor road facilities. 5th one is illiteracy and high social economy backwardness. So these are 5 problems. 5 problems of Indian society that is associated with agriculture. Okay, low level of irrigation system, that means still in many areas farmers use primitive type of farming. So, and land degradation, that means they are not taking land become barren after rotation of the crops. Okay, become barren land. Soil degraded its quality. Lack of proper knowledge, this means due to literacy, lack of knowledge. So they can't understand that is about crop rotation and proper access with to market. Proper assessor in which market they will buy the things or to sell the things. Okay, and that is only due to poor facilities, poor road facilities, poor vehicle facilities. All these are hurdles. Okay, and also the big problem is capital, high socio-economic backwardness, lack of capital, so they can't invest in cultivation. These are some hurdles that is associated with the farming. Now students, we will learn about Green Revolution. In my presentation, I have already explained you. I'm explaining today also, okay? For the Green Revolution. The Green Revolution in India refers to a period when Indian agriculture was converted into an industrial system. Industrial system due to technology, such as the use of high yielding variety seeds, then tractors, irrigation facilities, pesticides and fertilizers. Okay, it is mainly formed by Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Dr. M.S. Swaminathan is called the father of Green Revolution in India. Okay, so students, this is the extraordinary increase in the production of food grains in India after the mid-1960s is called the Green Revolution. Green Revolution has been possible in India because, just I have told you, because of new technologies that is introduced in Indian agriculture. Okay, so India is known as the home of spices. Our heritage, it is given because there is no other countries in the world that produces so many kinds of spices as India does. So you will learn and write the word bank you will learn and write. Okay, so what are the terms are given in the word bank? Explain the term. What you will write? Explain the terms. How many? There are four terms are given. Let us read that. Food crops. A crop cultivated primarily for human consumption. Cash crop. A crop cultivated primarily for the market. Okay. Rabi season, the agricultural season that commences from the middle of October. Kharif season, the agricultural season that commences from the first week of June and continues up to the November, December. Okay, so you write this in your classwork copy and memorize also. So read the chapter again and again. See the maps given in the chapter. Okay, go through the maps also. So this is what for today. The class ends here. Goodbye, students.